Hello everyone, welcome back to my videos. Today's topic is something about the microorganisms in food processing. So why these microorganisms have been extensively used in the production of certain useful food products. So this usefulness of microorganism is based on a natural phenomenon that is carried out by the microorganisms. So what is that natural phenomenon or the process? It is nothing but the fermentation process. So what is fermentation? Fermentation is the ability of microorganism, the natural ability of the microorganisms in the conversion. They are able to convert the carbohydrates into alcohol or acids. So we can define fermentation process as conversion of carbohydrates into alcohol and acids. So what are the group of microorganisms generally used in the food processing? So as usual, again, yeast, molds and bacteria have been extensively used in the process of in the production of certain useful products or in food processing. So if we consider, we can take this food processing or the fermentation process in our day-to-day lives as well. So in our daily household activities, we are generally eating, or in our food habits, we include curd. How this curd is prepared? This is nothing but again a very good example of fermentation. It is a very good example of the fermentation process, that is conversion of milk into curd involves the activity of certain microorganism, that is bacteria. So there also it is nothing but the fermentation process is carried out. The lactose, which is a kind of sugar present in milk, is converted into acid. So we are getting the end product in the form of curd. And one more example is the ripening of idli batter or dosa batter. There also the process involved is fermentation. So we can include this fermentation process, or we are using this fermentation process in our day-to-day lives as well. So coming to the examples of the microorganisms used are yeast, molds and bacteria. So firstly, yeast, amongst which Saccharomyces cerevisiae is a very good example and have been extensively used. Mostly this particular variety of yeast have been used industrially in the production of various kind of food products. Not only in food products, it has been used in non-food products also. And also Saccharomyces pastorianus. So this is one more example of yeast. So these two varieties have been used in production of wine, bread baking, alcohol, and also in the production of beer. Next is molds. Molds are nothing but they are fungi. They belong to fungi. And the examples of molds used in the food processing are Penicillium camemberti, Penicillium roqueforti, Penicillium chrysogenum, Aspergillus oryzae. So these varieties of fungi or molds have been used in the production of cheese, meat fermentation, and also in soya sauce. So not only in the production of food, but also they have been used, these molds, yeast or bacteria, are also being used in the production of, or in whatever the food product is produced. Addition of this particular microorganisms gives that particular food product desirable appearance, body texture, and also it adds peculiar flavors, or the very good flavors or aroma is also being added to the food products because of the usage of this microorganisms. So the examples of bacteria used in food processing are mostly the lactic acid bacteria is used in the food processing. So among which the examples are Carinobacterium, Enterococcus and Leuconostoc, which have been used in the production of cheese, sour cream, yogurt, meat products and also sausages. So these are the few examples of yeast, molds and bacteria which have been used in the food processing industry. So this is the brief overview about the microorganisms and the natural process based on which these microorganisms are used and the examples of the organisms and their useful products, the products produced by the respective microorganisms. So with this we are ending the topic of the influence of microorganisms on humankind. That's all for the video. Thank you for watching. Thanks once again.